Hello everyone and welcome back to the ESL 1 Frankfurt 2016 Chinese Qualifiers. This is game 1 of a best of 3 between Vichy Gaming and The Wings Gaming. I'm Lily, of course, and Chu is going to be casting with me if he's there. Are you there? Looks like he's still AFK, as is classic for Chu. So anyway, best of 3, like I said, Chu has now disappeared, so I guess he'll be back later.
VG Gaming's turn to pick.
There we go. Yeah. You're back. Hello. Radiant. How you doing?
Great. Just watching some cosplay. Cosplay competition, man. Sick.
So, Wings. They did actually win the last ESL Frankfurt, but we haven't seen anything from them since their game against Team Liquid, so not too sure what to expect from them. Though this will be quite interesting, as Ice did used to be on a team with ROTK and Bernie and Big God, so he's sort of versing his old teammates. A little bit of a Chinese rival going on there. Vichy Gaming, we've seen a little bit more from them. They tend to play a bit of rotation between Siler and CTY. Either one of them sort of play mid, but they've been favoring the Morphling recently, so I wouldn't be surprised if we did see Siler playing that Morphling. But what are you feeling for these games? This best of three.
Yeah, as you said, we haven't really seen any action from Wings game. ESL Frankfurt, which they won. Yeah, they really played really well. But I must say that Wings Gaming, they're very unique because other than the Witch Doctor pick, all the other there's really no pattern with all the other four heroes. Like they just switch up heroes nonstop. They have like a huge hero pool. Whereas for VG Gaming, I mean, you just look at their players, it's quite predictable what Tika can and cannot play, what Scylla can and cannot play. They've been around for quite a while. We know what they're good at and what they're not.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I mean, Scylla's hero is like you said, the Morphling, hard carries, even heroes like Lycan, Scylla's just the kind of person that can play any hard carry.
Yeah, they are much more well-known players. Wings Gaming are sort of relatively new players to the Chinese scene. And oh my god, that guy's name is in characters. Oh no. Who would that be? That would be...
Which guy?
Teal? Whose name is in...
Teal? You mean the one in Chinese characters, is it?
Yeah, so there's Shadow, who's Carry. That must be Blink.
Yes, correct. It's Blink. Okay. His basically his name means Blink Dagger. Yep.
Okay. Alright, so that's Blink there. Anyway, so looking at the band. So Bounty Hunter, Enchantress, pretty standard. Doom and Beastmaster, again pretty standard. Invoker, Alchemist, Lich and Juggernaut. Vichy Gaming, like I said, they've been running mid Scylla as a Morphling with a Lich support by Burning. So that Lich ban, a strong ban out in itself, but it will be countering VG if they do want to go for that Lich Morphling combo. Also, is your mic on in game? Have you turned it on?
Yep, it is.
Okay, so it's showing up on the side for you.
What? Twitch? What? What about Twitch?
No, is it showing up on the side for you?
Yeah, it is.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Alright, awesome. So a Wisp pick or EO coming out from Wings Gaming. So VG, how are they going to respond? They have picked the Wisps themselves in the past. So Wings maybe just sort of counterpicking, or maybe just Wings wanted to take the Wisp for themselves. Of course, Tiny is still in the pool and he would be relatively strong this game. So Vichy Gaming might want to try and ban him out in the next phase if they can. And obviously they're thinking very hard about this pick. What do you think they should take to sort of counter this? Well, very heavy nuke damage and stuns coming out from Wings Gaming thus far.
I mean, you can always take the classic IO counters like Disruptor, even Enigma. Yeah. I guess they're opting more for the, you know, going defensive with the Dazzle, with the Weave to counteract the amplify damage, the heals, the graves. I must say that VG Gaming, they aren't gonna be as mobile as Wings Gaming.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean you can't really beat an IO with free to locate, so but yeah, I mean the first two picks for VG Gaming are like classic picks, like Lion, Tyranitar. We all know who's gonna play a Tyranitar, which is obviously ROTK. Medusa coming out, so yeah, Wings Gaming is just pretty much unpredictable at the moment. You can really play anything.
Yeah. It is hard to tell given how little we've seen from Wings. And Vichy Gaming now, they've got their two supports in their offlaner. They probably don't want to play too late against the Medusa slaughter unless they decide to take something like the Anti-Mage as their hard carry. But then Anti-Mage against slaughter isn't really that good anyway, so they probably, I would say, want to take something that can break the base at around about sort of the 30 to 35 minute mark, just ending the game before Medusa really comes online. Or do you think that they would be better to try and just play late against Wings? What do you think is going to be better for them?
I think VG Gaming can opt for two routes. One is just pick a Lycan and go for fast push. Because yeah, Lycan's just going to eat your Witch Doctor and IO. Or actually, Anti-Mage is actually still a good pick. I mean, it isn't really counted that much by Slada. I mean, okay, the M damage really deals a huge amount of damage.
Yeah.
You have Lion and Tyranitar for lockdown. You have Dazzle to really keep you in alive. So I think the hard counter of Anti-Mage versus Medusa is still okay.
Yep.
But I think the hero that VGM should really just pick right now is just Nyx Assassin. I mean, it's just the biggest counter to Medusa.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Or they can pick a Slug even if they want to go late. Yeah, just one of those. And I say like Anti-Mage Lycan Slug would be like probably the best heroes because like, you know, those are Scylla heroes. But yeah, we see the Morphling coming out, so they really want to fight late against the Medusa.
Well, Sala has been playing that Morphling a lot, like I said, so this will be interesting. Do you think the Medusa's going to go to the mid lane against Sala, or do you think this is going to be an easy lane Medusa? Medusa Wisp on the mid with Wisp stacking, that could be quite strong, couldn't it? Remaining.
I think it'll be fine if they put Medusa mid. It'd be more suited for them. I still feel VG Gaming still needs a hero to, in a sense, hard counter Medusa.
Yeah,
I think Nyx Assassin would be perfect. It's not so much with this lineup at the moment. A bit hard. I guess it can still fit it in.
Yeah.
But Nyx Assassin is like just a pure counter to Medusa and nothing else.
Yeah, I think Nyx would be strong. It would be a little bit hard to the laning because they wouldn't really have a one position, but as in the laning phase. But it would be really nice against that Medusa. Nyx Assassin is incredibly strong. And I wonder if Wings are just going to opt to ban him out. But they're going to get rid of the Slark, so another strong hero. VG Gaming have got room right now for sort of another semi-carry. Otherwise, maybe they want to take something to just take towers down. So maybe something like a Death Prophet. If they want to run sort of a 2-1-2.
They're battling out a bit rider, so they are. So, VG Gaming are thinking that Medusa's gonna be mid, Slada's gonna be the safe lane. Safe lane Slada's actually really, really strong too.
Yep.
Like, just get a fast upload dagger is really, really strong. I think VG Gaming can afford to go quite greedy, which is why I think Wiz Gaming banned out the Slug. Because you wouldn't want to play the game against like a Morphling Slug and a Tidehunter. I guess.
Ooh, Storm.
Radiant team pick. So I guess relatively like newer picks coming out.
Yeah.
We haven't really seen that much Storm on VG Gaming, and actually we haven't seen Storm on VG Gaming for like ages, man. Yeah. 10 seconds remaining.
We did see Storm. Ferrari played him last night, but other than that, Storm's probably been pretty bare from the meta of late. He has got a buff with the Arcanum Scepter now. It's a bit of a buff, I suppose, but Arcanum Scepter is a big item to pick up on a Storm Spirit. We'll have to see how this fares. So maybe do you think the Morphling's going to go mid or the Storm going to go mid? Because typically Storm is a mid hero, but when I've seen Scylla pick up the Morphling, he always goes mid. And a Night Stalker.
Alright, so they're just really opting for really, really tanky heroes. I still feel that Wings Gaming could have opted for maybe one more defensive, in a sense, defensive kind of hero.
Yeah.
Because like they have a Slada and a Medusa to do a lot of things already. So, but I guess they picked a Night Stalker for maybe the silence, the map control, especially against the Storm Spirit and the Morphling. That's really important, and he's tanky at the same time. So, three tanky calls and supports generally like healing.
I think the Night Stalker is quite a good pickup this game, considering the draft from Vichy Gaming. The silence is going to be incredibly valuable against this Morphling, Storm Spirit, even the Dazzle in the line. Actually, all of them, apart from the Tidehunter, are countered quite hard by the silence. The only hero that I could think that would be even nicer is an Ancient Apparition, but obviously they already have their two supports, so unless they were going to run something like Wisp Core, they'd be unable to. And looking at the hero picks, we've got Shadow, level 1 Smoke Gank coming out there from Wings. Shadow on the Medusa, he looks like he's heading to mid. Blink, if I forget his name midway through the game, I'm sorry. that's Slada. Looks like it's Easy Lane Slada, possibly, yep. Night Stalker there being played by Faith Bian. Witch Doctor being played by Ice Ice. And Wisp being played by Innocence. On the side of Vichy Gaming, we have got ROTK on, that Tidehunter on the offlane. Lion there being played... God, my camera's gone a little bit crazy. Oh no, Lion's name is in... Nope, never mind, sorry, it's him. playing the Lion. Storm Spirit there by CTY. Syla on the Morphling. And Burning on the Dazzle.
It's just kind of weird to see Burning on support role.
Yeah.
It's been quite a while. He's been on the support role quite a while, but it's still, it's pretty hard to shift the stereotype or whatever it is called. And Burning has been like a carry for like ages.
He was the carry. Burning was the ultimate carry. It is funny though how both him and ROTK keep saying, yeah, we're retiring, and they always come back. They can't quit it.
That's your Chinese retirement for you. I think Russian retirements are the real kind of retirements. Like, who was it? Light of Heaven, Ask Art. Yeah, when they say they retire, they really, really retire.
Yeah.
But when it comes to Chinese retirement, this is what Chinese retirement is.
They retire and then they reform a team like 6 months later. Alright, so in terms of items, Wisp looks like he's rushing a bottle. He's got 500 gold in the bank, so do you think they're going to give the rune to him, or do you think they're just going to give it to Shadow?
I think they can just give it to Shadow.
Yeah. And for this offlane, who is going to the offlane? Because it looks like Faith is going for the Iron Talons or jungling build. Are they just abandoning the offlane altogether?
The battle begins.
Stupendous. Night Stalker's definitely on the offlane. He can totally abandon the offlane if he wants to. I wouldn't suggest so, because I think you can get quite a bit of the offlane. But then again, I think Iron Talon or Night Stalker, he farms really fast. He farms the jungle really fast. Yeah. But I don't quite agree with this like jumping straight into jungle, because knowing that VG Gaming knows that, there's gonna be a duo mid like a Wisp and a Medusa, he can probably like tackle a duo lane at top.
Yeah.
And at the same time, Io's gonna be stacking, so it doesn't make sense for him to take the neutrals. But I guess he's jungling quite fast. I mean, he just destroyed the big camp in like less than 30 seconds.
Yeah.
Level 2 already.
Well, that is the power of the Iron Talon. You can farm very, very quickly in the jungle with it. So I guess he will just get a little bit of farm before he rotates up. So it is going to be giving complete free farm to Syla, but I don't think it's too much of a worry. I mean, Morphling in the early game can really destroy that. The Slada in the early game can really destroy the Morphling. If he gets up a fast Blink Dagger, I'd be a little bit more scared of a Slada than I would be of a Morphling, just because of the pure damage coming out. Like I said, if he goes for that Armlet Blink build, he'll be, have very high damage output, and he'll be quite tanky as well. Whereas Morphling usually morphs quite a bit into agility, and it's not till later when he gets up a couple more items that he'll actually get the strength items up. Which leads him to be quite squishy. And Witchdoctor as well, Ice, he is going for the Maledict build. So you'll often see Witchdoctors these days opting to max out either Voodoo Restoration or Maledict. Typically Voodoo Restoration, but he's gone for the Maledict, so very damage oriented. Expect some kills on ROTK on the bot lane if they get the opportunity to.
It's just one level in Maledict, so probably just for, you know, just to harass. But I would feel the Voodoo Restoration would be more valuable.
There you go, he's just throwing the Maledict down on ROTK. Yeah. Harassing ROTK quite
effectively.
They're
always on that team, so it's like double heal.
Yeah. Well, in last hits, at the moment, Vichy Gaming are doing a little bit better. I'm about to sneeze. Hang on. Wait, I'm not. Oh no, I've got that. You know that feeling when you're about to sneeze and then you don't sneeze and then you're gonna sneeze? Sorry. I might randomly sneeze in a second. So Storm Spirit is actually doing quite well in the mid lane in terms of last hits, but it looks like he's been out harassed. And Medusa, of course, becomes scarier and scarier as the laning phase goes on, because once she gets up, you know, max level of our Mystic Snake, it really, really hurts. And it's very hard to dodge in the mid lane because you've got limited areas where you can last hit the creeps. So, I mean, Storm Spirit especially is a low range hero who's only got 480 range, so he always has to stand reasonably close to the creep wave. So if Medusa times her snakes correctly, they will pretty much always hit the Storm Spirit just like that. So very hard lane for CTY, I would say. But do you think CTY will be able to get a kill on the Medusa later, or will it be a little bit too hard with the Nightstalker and the Wisp being so close by?
First things first, Dragonlance on Storm Spirit.
Do you think they're gonna
secondly,
go?
I don't think they can get a kill on Medusa, because I think the reason why you put Medusa mid is so that she can get relatively good farm and at the same time get levels really quickly.
Yeah.
So I mean, by the time Storm hits 6, she'll probably be 6. Can't really jump on a Medusa with Stone Gaze and probably level 2 mana shield. She'll probably level up the Mystic Snake.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, she can become tanky really, really fast with the fast levels. Quite impossible to kill Medusa unless you probably have like a 3-man gank or maybe a DD rune.
We need something. I mean, it is interesting. The Medusa is really giving CTY a hard time. He's pretty much constantly on low health, varying himself pots, and yet, you know, 23 to 14 versus 16 to 3, he's absolutely getting trashed in the last hits. CTY is just, I suppose showing his experience. You know, CTY is a little bit more experienced in the competitive Dota scene than Shadow. Shadow's a relatively new player, so.
I would expect CTY to, as in, I would feel that CTY is more mechanically skilled.
Yeah.
Shadow.
Definitely.
Because he's been around longer and he's one of the...
Bot lane initiation on RTK, but Burning is there to back him up. Heal coming out, Grave is up as well, and RT is going to be fine. So, carry on.
Yeah, CTY is just one of the bigger names when it comes to mid lane. And he's getting, I think he's just getting more last hits because he has Remnant. And he can use the overload damage for better last hits.
Top lane, caught the end of that kill there. Faith and Y Innocence taking down Sylar for first blood. I mean, I suppose that's what we were saying earlier. Oh, and as I'm kind of ranting on, they take down Ice on the bot lane as well. Now Burning is in trouble. He's going to go down. That's a 2-for-1 trade there. Okay. But yeah, big kill on Sila there. And exchanging his support for support. And it looks like actually they're going to go on RTK on the bot lane as well. Chasing after him. Blink not really doing very much damage. And Wisp is going to lose that tether. He's just going to back out. Looks like he wants to try and get the kill. Lion missing the stun there. But Blink is going to be forced to back out with 4 rotations. CTY is there to join the party as well, but he's out of mana. Ice could be in trouble. He's throwing the stun down onto Burning. He's going to be doing a little bit of damage. Wisp tethering in. Him is there though. There's going to be the courier flying in. But no, both are just going to disengage and back out. So I guess it's a little bit of farm there for the Medusa to catch up.
Yeah, just buying quite a bit of space for the Medusa to farm. I don't think he... I think it's less of how HYM... I'm gonna call him HYM.
Yep.
He misses stun, but it's more of how Blink managed to dodge it.
Yeah. It was good movement by Blink. And it is...
I just want to mention that Nightstalker at 6 minutes, he's level 6, so that's really, really quick for and a supposed to be an off lane Night Stalker. I mean, he got a kill, top against Syla, but I mean, jungle Night Stalker is just too fast. He's like 500 gold away from his Midas.
It's very, very close to that Midas. And that will get him very fast levels and experience, which he really needs, as well as securing him that farm, which I think is going to be a very smart item choice for him. He's going to be wanting to play very, very aggressively, and if he can score some kills as well and have that Midas, he'll farm very fast. But even if he doesn't manage to get the kills that he's after, just having that Midas up is going to make sure that he never really falls too far behind. And the smoke coming out from HYM now. Might be trying to go for a gank. It looks like Innocence is just sort of lurking on the top lane. They probably want to try and kill Syla, but it is very hard. He's already got his strength treads up as well as his Aquila, and he's got a pot in the bank, so he's ready to escape from any foul attempts in his life. Nice Ice now just going to be finding Burning RTK there as well, but this is a very defensive dual lane. It's very hard to kill a Tide Dazzle lane, especially with this Dazzle. Burning is maxing out Shallowgrave in the heal, so not even bothering to get sort of a point in Poison Touch. He just wants pure defensive capabilities.
HYM is actually just stacking out the Ancients for the Tide Hunter later on. He just missed the stack, but yes, three stacks is still quite a lot of gold and levels. He can probably share that with the Dazzle or maybe himself.
Both Ancients are stacked up a bit. And it might be a point of contention. I mean, Medusa can, once she gets a little bit more farm and a couple levels in Split Shot, she can farm the Ancients fairly well. So depending on how much experience she gets, maybe they'll be able to contest that Ancient stack at some point soon. Depends. But a smoke gank now coming out from HYM and CTY. They're going to be rotating towards the bottom lane. Only level 3 on the line at 8 minutes. That's actually quite significant. Him and the Dazzle are severely underleveled, and it looks like now RTK just baiting a little bit. He's taking some damage from the tower. They will be revealed. Ice Ice is standing in the trees. They're going to catch sight of Ice Ice. Stun coming out. Ice Ice taking a lot of damage. Not going to be able to get that stun off because of the Hex from HYM, and just one little kill there. Not too much contest coming out from the Radiant. There was a rotation from Innocence. He's standing in the trees, and Blink is hiding in the trees too. Looks like push going to be happening onto this tower. Ravage is up though. CTY is teleporting back to the mid lane, so now it looks like a good time for them to go. And yeah, Blink does decide to leave that hiding place from behind the trees.
Yeah, really good pick off there. Don't know whether it was really worth it because they left Medusa in mid, farming quite a bit. Actually, Medusa has opted for like a 0-4-4-0 build, so no Stone Gaze, which actually makes her incredibly tanky at level 8. I don't think she's pretty much unkillable unless it's like a 3 or 4 main gank. Yeah. She definitely won't be farming Ancients anytime soon.
No.
Stitch. Don't know whether you
bot lane initiation on Burning. He is just gonna grave himself, but I don't think he's getting out of this one. He could teleport, he's gonna try, but no, they got too many cancels. The void coming out from the Night Stalker just to kill him off there. Yeah, Medusa is very, very tanky, and she's getting a lot of free farm. CTY keeps rotating around, so we will have to see. Oh, top lane actually. Syla going to be initiated on as well. Wishwatcher just laying down the ultimate. Stun coming out from Blink as well. And I think Syla is going to be going down. He can't get away from that. And Wings doing quite well. 4-2 on the board right now. Killed Syla twice, which is really important because he is, you know, the one position. He's getting a lot of farm because his team is trying to make space for him, but it's not quite working out.
That's actually a really good play. Both Ice Ice and Blink. We see the synergy of the Amp damage along with the Death Ward coming out.
Yeah.
Looks like they actually want to go for a kill on mid lane. This is actually what they need.
Him coming in, he's going to get the stun off. CTY following up. No Electric Vortex, so not quite enough stuns. And Shadow's just going to turn around, chasing them down, but decides to back out. Ice Ice and Innocence teleported in, just ready to defend the Medusa. And they really do nearly kill this Medusa. I mean, it's quite important given that Shadow's just been AFK farming while Sala's getting shut down. But unfortunately, this highly defensive team from Wings is just keeping him alive. The Wisp and the Witch Doctor. I mean, that combo is very, very hard to kill. They've got the negative damage taken there from the overcharge, as well as the double heal. So you've got the Voodoo Restoration and then the Voodoo Restoration from the Wisp, you know, buffing you up. And not they have the Voodoo Restoration yet, but in future they will. Yeah, it's very, very hard to sort of kill anyone.
Yeah, and the thing is that I think it was the third pink Medusa, right? What was the fourth pick for VG? Was it Dazzle? I think it was Morphling.
And then Storm was the fifth pick.
Fourth pick, and then the last pick was Storm. So, like, they really, really have nothing against the Medusa. They have no damage at all. Like, even if they, like, for that smoke gang, wasted smoke gang in mid, it was just the Storm and the Lion. And they really have no damage against it. Even if they had Dazzle right there just to help them out with the damage, still not enough damage. I think to counter Medusa, you really need either a mana burner or, like, just a lot of chain stuns here and there.
Well, I think one thing worth noting is HYM has actually gone for level 2 in the mana drain, so he's not maxing out the Earth Spike. So I think that they realize that they really need some way to shut the Medusa down, and Lion is going to be it. And actually, on top lane, Sylar going to get initiated on the stun, the silence coming out. Death Ward as well. He's trying to keep himself alive, but it looks like he might be taking a fall. He's taking a lot of damage. Is he going to go down? No, he's not. He's going to be okay. And actually, they get a kill on Blink on the bot lane while this engage on top was happening.
Yeah, so see the tankiness of Morphling. I mean, he managed to get his strength morph off in time, so he managed to survive. Whereas on bot lane, CDY just zipped in, followed by the hex stun and the finger, so definitely not gonna survive that combo.
But of course, the Medusa is still unanswered for. And she is going to be going for the Lincoln Sphere build, looks like. She has got up the Perseverance first. And actually, CTY could be in trouble. He's going to get silenced up, but HYM is there. Blink coming out from Blink. He's going to be chasing after, but no, invisibility on the Storm Spread. He should be okay for now. Hiding himself in the Roshan pit. And this is a time when VG has to watch out, because they do have that Night Stalker. Nighttime is the time to be afraid.
Yeah, just limited vision from the darkness. And actually, only just have one ward, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, just one ward out there. Not really giving them that much information. So, whereas on Wings, they have like three, four
wards. Like,
yeah, both offensive and defensive. So, they're gonna know exactly what G is doing. This just looks like the typical, like, 4 protect 1 in a sense. I mean, Sylar's just gonna be farming and the rest are gonna be mid.
Yeah. Actually, they do catch the smoke gank using that, the scan. So I think it's like the first time I've seen the scan used in the past couple of games.
It was actually a big error, because when they smoked, they actually smoked CTY along. And CDY flew into the crit wave and revealed like that he was smoked.
Yeah.
Which is why Wings threw out a scan there, so
looks like, are they gonna try and Roshan? Do you think they have the damage to do this? They don't have any negative armor, do they?
They need all my heroes, yeah.
Alright, looks like they're gonna go for a 5-man Rosh attempt.
Yeah, but there's a ward scouting and they really take it really slowly. Wings really need to move right now. Stop taking the Ancients, move towards the Roche pit right now.
Slowest Roshan ever, but uncontested. Smoke gank?
Alright, I'm gonna go for a smoke, so both teams know what's up.
Alright, and then they come CTY, gonna be trying to grab the ring. He's gonna get stunned out there by Blink, but a nice 2-man stun by HYM, gonna be keeping him alive. Ravage coming out now as well, and in they go. They're gonna be able to take down Blink. Wisp trying to save the day, not gonna be able to grab anyone. Now, Wishdoctor Ward from the high ground, they're gonna be doing a lot of damage there under Shadow, including the Finger of Death, and they will finally take him down. Double kill there for CTY, and now Innocence is in a little bit of a fury of he's gonna teleport right back into the whole team. And wow, that was a massively won fight there for Vichy Gaming. really nice stun from Lion, catching both the Medusa as well as the Slaughter. I think that pretty much saved the team fight for them, and that's going to be a free Roshan.
I think while VG Gaming doesn't really have that much damage, I mean, with regards to like Lion, Dazzle, and Storm, when they try to gank the Medusa, their team fight is actually extremely strong.
Yeah.
And also, Wings Gaming actually don't really have that much damage on their side either. I don't know whether it would have helped if the Medusa got his Stone Gaze off earlier, because he had a couple of chances to hit the Stone Gaze. But I doubt that would have helped at all, because like there's really no damage on Wings on Wings Gaming side. Wings Gaming just really tries on like maybe pick-offs because of Slaughter and Nice Talker and the relocate. Yeah. They're just banking everything out on the Medusa.
I mean, I would say Wings Gaming have got really good single target. Like you said, with the Slaughter, the amplified damage, and then the Witch Doctor ultimate. But in terms of the AoE, they are lacking, and that's where Vici Gaming really excel, because they've got the Ravage, they've got the Lion, who... These Earth Spikes coming out in all these games seem to be like 3 or 4 man stuns, which is just amazing. So AoE teamfight, I would say, definitely goes to Vici Gaming. So Wings, I think they should continue focusing on their pickoffs, which they probably will do fairly soon. Nightstalker is... well, pretty much has his Argonim Scepter, he just needs one more CS, and that will definitely help. The second night will be coming up in around about 2 minutes, I think, and that will be their time to shine. Probably can't kill the Storm Spirit at the moment because he does have the Aegis, but they should be good to get a pickoff or two on maybe Burning or the Lion, depending on how they play this game. But the Ags will really, really help with that map control. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. And actually, they're playing quite aggressively right now from Vici Gaming. No Ravage up, but they've only got 5 more seconds to wait. Burning just throwing down a solo ult onto Shadow. They really want to keep him as squishy as possible. He's got a DD rune, so he might be interested in taking a fight. His Linked Sphere isn't done yet, so that's his defensive item not quite complete. Whereas Syla has got his Linked Sphere done. And actually, it looks like they're going to go straight in onto Shadow, waiting for that maximum duration on the Dazzle's weave. But it looks like the Wisp is going to be saving his life, teleporting him out. Innocence needs to,
He needs a Stone Gaze before the relocate comes out.
Are they going to be bringing the Medusa back in?
Yeah, he needs a Stone Gaze now.
They are Stone Gaze nice. Going in. Ravage is up. They're going to be doing a lot of damage. Looks like CTY is the target of choice. He has got the Aegis though, and looks like Ravage going to be coming out now. Not going to be catching the Witch Doctor, so he's still charging that ultimate up. ROTK making a run back out. Innocence is still alive, unfortunately. Now HYM misses the stun. He tried to do something big, but didn't quite, match up, and now RTK going down, HYM dying on the sideline, CTY is going to be making a run for it, Burning just going to grave and teleport out, and that was a bit of a disastrous fight there for Vici Gaming. Just sort of kited around. Are they going to keep chasing? Blink is going forward. They do have Syla, they will get the silence off. He does not have the strength morph going, so he could be in a little bit of trouble. He did have an opportunity, he has got it on now, a stun coming out there from the Witch Doctor, and CTY intelligently moved away so they didn't bounce back and forth between the two of them. And he will be able to teleport out. Now blinking into the trees. Getting stuck, but it's okay. Getting freed there by Innocence. And 6-6 on the board, but that was definitely a one fight there for Wings.
Radiant's bottom tower. Yeah, I actually don't know why Blink actually went in to try and stun up Syla when... Yeah, I mean... He TP'd out from there. Yeah, I mean... He definitely needed, Shadow definitely needed to get the Stone Gaze off before the video game came out, and
yeah.
It's quite, that VG Gaming thought they could take that fight. It's playing a little bit of, like, naivety.
Yeah.
Yeah, but really good counter initiation from Wings, from the Stone Gaze to, I guess the Stone Gaze really helps, with, the M damage, everything's physical.
Yeah. It's massive physical damage if anyone gets frozen.
They expanded the Ravage, but got nothing out of that. So...
I feel like ROTK was a little bit late on that Ravage, as in he was trying to save, you know, a 5-man Ravage, but by the time he got it off, everyone was sort of already dead. And plus, he didn't hit with the Witch Doctor, which is sort of crucial. I mean, Lion has now got his Blink Dagger up, so HYM is going to be able to initiate in on that Witch Doctor when necessary, but... It felt like that whole fight was a little bit chaotic, which is not really what you expect from, players like that. And actually CTY could be in trouble. He's going to get stunned. The silence is going to be coming out next. Witch Doctor ultimate. He doesn't even get the opportunity to kill himself. Just deaded. immediately deaded.
It's actually quite an important pickoff.
Yeah. With that Bloodstone.
Getting the Bloodstone charges down as much as possible. Starting Bloodstone charges is now 12. Now down to 8. Yeah, I think Duny, like, Bloodstone still works on Storm Spirit just because he needs the raw HP and the potential amount of like mana regen he can get from that item.
Yeah.
But he just needs to rack up the Bloodstone charges. Just avoid deaths and just try and pick off the Witch Doctor and Wisp as much as possible.
Yeah, that is pretty much his goal. Do you think we're going to be seeing the, I think it's called Bloodthorn, the new item on that Storm Spirit this game? Or do you think you should just keep it as an Orchid?
I mean, definitely a Bloodthorn if it goes like super ultra late game, because that's the only item progression from Orchid, right? It's a huge damage item. A great team item also, because of just everybody's attacks doing crits. I mean, you have excess amount of gold, you definitely want to get a Bloodthorn.
Yeah. So it looks like both teams are gearing up for a fight right now. They do have a little bit of an advantage on Wingside because it is nighttime, but daytime is coming soon. Avicii Gaming might want to hold just for another 30 seconds or so until daytime has occurred. And both teams are just a little bit of an impasse. They're both just standing around. Faith Bian considering going around the back lines. ROTK is standing quite aggressively, but he does have the Blink Dagger, so he might want to keep himself out of vision, but of course they can see him. Nightstalker having that ag, so he is in vision. Even though he thinks he's hidden, he's definitely not. The Wings team standing on the sideline there. Nice Stalker now popping his ultimate. Sylar using the wave just to farm. The team's just dancing.
I have this feeling that whoever goes on whoever first, whoever starts the engagement is going to lose.
Yeah, that's why their boats get to go in.
If you start the engage on the Medusa, the relocate will just come out. And Medusa are so tanky. At the same time, if you want to start an engage, you can't really reach the back line if you're Wings Gaming. The only person who is right in front is ROTK, and you don't want to engage on ROTK.
Don't want to engage on a tide, that's usually a bad idea. Looks like, yeah, they're just going to back out. I think that's very true. I mean, both teams have got great defensive capabilities. There's the Wisp and there's Burning. And Burning is positioning himself very well. I mean, he's standing quite far at the back. Right now, he might be a little bit too far forward, but he's usually positioning himself sort of at the back in the trees, ready to just grave at a moment's notice. And he did just use the weave defensively. So last time, he threw the weave down on Shadow, which did not work out on them. So it looks like now they've opting to just use the weave on themselves. But they're going to get this tier 2 without contest. It is daytime now, and I think VG were just waiting for that, like I said. They were waiting for the daytime to come, and then they're good to push because Wings have put a lot into this Nightstalker, you know, getting up this Arcanum Scepter rather early, and so they need to utilize it. Because that's pretty much all the Nightstalker is good for right now. Giving them, like, nice bird vision during the night.
Surprised that Wings actually didn't want to defend that, but I guess they realized that the daytime was coming. So they just wanted to just, hey, why not we just send our Witch Doctor on some missions and just plant some wards. Which he did, he planted a ward in the mid tier 2 tower. Sacrificing a tier 2 tower, I think it's generally fine. I think when it comes to Medusa, sacrificing any amount of towers, even Mega Creeps is fine, because Medusa is just one of those heroes that can really fight against Mega Creeps.
Yeah. Well, both teams are just sort of hanging back a little bit. In terms of net worth, it's fairly even. Net worth total is favoring Vichy Gaming just a little bit, about 3,000. Experience is basically dead even, which shows how close this game is. Both teams have got great late game potential. The Morphling is one of the best late game carries, and so is Medusa. So this game could really go either way. What do you think is going to be the play for Vichy Gaming to win, and what do you think is going to be the play for Wings to win? Think they're just better both to farm, or should maybe one of them focus on split pushing, or what do you think they should do?
Wings Gaming doesn't really, definitely doesn't have any split pushing potential. VG Gaming has a split pushing potential with
not even with the Wisp.
I mean, a Wisp relocate. You probably only want to expand a relocate to do split pushing if like you're gonna take the Rex or potentially like down the tier 2 tower, like
yeah.
The tier 2 tower has just a bit of HP left. But like I said, VG with the Morphling and the Replicate, and yeah, with eventually it's gonna get a BOT, so there's gonna be a lot of split pushing action. But I think generally VG have the upper hand here, because firstly they go for Roche, and secondly I think in the late game when it comes to when they do smokes into clashes, if Tyranitar can get really really good ravages off and they can burst down the two supports, I don't think there's anything Wings can do anything.
Yeah.
Wings can do anything about it, especially with CTY like just jumping around. There's really nothing to stop CTY from jumping around. So, especially when it gets DK.
Radiant weren't sure where the Dire were. I guess they didn't time Roshan. Maybe they thought maybe they were ganking around here and they went for a smoke gank the enemy jungle, but didn't find anything. And what do you think about Sylas' choice of getting Ethereal Blade first? Think that's a right item for this game?
I think it's a good pickup.
Yeah.
There's actually a better. I don't think like a Manta style or Scarlet would have done a better job, because all they just need to do is just burst down the supports, or like just the burst potential. Yeah, I mean, if I can picture like the best sort of engagement VG can get, Blink to Ravage, Ethereal Blade, Strike, burst one, two heroes down, and then there's pretty much one fight for Wings.
Yeah.
For VG.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I mean, it's, you can tell how tense both these teams are, and this seems like honestly a very even matchup. I wasn't too sure given that Vichy Gaming is now sort of they're the B Vichy Gaming team. Vichy Gaming Reborn is meant to be the A team, but they're obviously doing quite well.
Wings. See, this VG team just feels like the old boys team.
Yeah.
Just a bunch of old boys banded up and then just playing Dota just for fun.
Yeah, that's the impression I got too, especially because, you know, they keep saying they're retiring and then coming back and all that. Feels like they're just sort of, they're playing because they love the game. And obviously they're playing very well, though I can imagine. But both ROTK and I think it's Burning, both of them are fairly noisy from what I've heard. ROTK definitely is a bit of a noisy player, so honestly I'd like to see their team chat. It'd be quite funny. And shouting at each other. ROTK faking out a ravage there. Right now, Wings have got the high ground as well as the Nightstalker advantage, so I can imagine that Vichy Gaming are keen to take a fight around here. ROTK playing a little bit aggressively, staying so far forward. He's hard to kill, but they could possibly get a kill on him if they really wanted to. But looks like he will be backing out now. I mean, what next? What do you think Medusa should get next? She's got a Manta up. Should she go for something like pure damage? Or should she go for more survivability, like Ascari?
I think Butterfly would be actually the next item to go for.
Yep.
They really need damage at the moment, because right now they're just pure tankiness.
Yeah.
But yeah, being purely tanky isn't really going to win you engages. And currently VG have the upper hand, because they have the better engage. Storm Spirit is the Aegis. Looks like Slada wants to get engaged on.
I mean, they're really just sort of kiting around the issue. CTY is sitting quite aggressively. Faith has vision of him. I like the way that Faith is playing, because he knows that they have limited vision. In fact, he's going to go for the silence. Storm Spirit could be in trouble. He's still got the Aegis though, so he should be fine. RTK now blinking forward onto Wings. Shadow just going to be able to walk away. Now, two-man stun coming out from Blink. That was very nicely done, but CTY immediately fighting in. Ice throwing out the Death Ward. Going to be doing a lot of damage. Ravage now coming out, landing onto two, but they do manage to get off the Stone Gaze. ROTK is going to be frozen up, but Syla does manage to take down Faith at BN during that fight. Now, Ice is on the run. He's pretty much the last one standing in this team fight. The rest of his team has teleported out. They're going to be chasing after him. Are they going to manage to catch him? Yes, they will. CTY running right in. But the double man stun actually coming out, not going to be enough though. Syla taking off Y at the back line too. Sort of chasing after Shadow half-assedly, but not going to do it. And a 4-for-2 exchange at the end of that fight, was it?
Yep, 4-for-2, just the two supports on VG's side.
Didn't even lose the Aegis.
Like in the damage department. They actually started and engaged quite well with a double kill on Witch Doctor from the Death Ward.
Yeah.
But just not enough damage to close out the engage. Just Tanda just took his time, blinked in, did a ravage, and yeah, the rest is history. Wings just fell apart. Slada dying, Witch Doctor dying.
It is sort of showing the power of this hard nuking damage and why it's sort of necessary. I mean, in terms of nukes, Wings has basically just got the void and I suppose the Slardar stun as well, and that's about it. Everything else is just sort of slow nuking damage, and while they should be good in long engages, it is very hard against a Dazzle, because Dazzle is great in long engages as well. He's just healing everyone up and keeping them all alive. So I think that is the problem from Wings. The two defensive supports is great in theory, but it's just not working out in practice against this Dazzle. And I personally feel like Burning is doing a great job in really keeping these engages going his team's way. He's giving them enough time to sort of, for Scylla to pick off the supports, and Medusa just isn't as mobile. I mean, she'd love to be able to get close to, you know, Burning and pick him off, whereas Scylla and CTY are just being able to ruffle ball in or waveform in and just pick off the supports, whereas Medusa's just standing at the back lines thinking, I would really like to go in and get one, but I can't. And she is going for the butterfly, picking up the Eagle Song, so.
Yeah, definitely need damage. I mean, the only other item that she could have gone for is Divine, but I mean...
Divine next would be a little risky.
I mean, if you're going for Divine, you must make sure your IO is there. You're always there to really back you up.
Yeah.
And not die and engage, so... I'm guessing VG, when they did that draft, they were fine with like the Wisp and the Witch Doctor, and after seeing the Medusa, they decided, hey, we can go greedy, we can just pick as many cores as we like. I mean, Storm generally quite a bit of farm, Morphling Reeds a ton of farm.
Yeah.
But when they do, they dish out a lot of damage, and at the same time, they are incredibly tanky. Like Morphling can just strength gain. Tyander is naturally tanky. Storm Spirit with the Bloodstone and now with the Lincolns. No lockdown for Storm Spirit. So VG Gaming just looking on top on all aspects at the moment. Wings just need damage at the moment.
Okay, fight coming out now. Ravage is up but not going to be coming out. Now, immediately, Burning taking a lot of damage. He's going to be going down in exchange for... Ice. Shadow standing in the middle of the team fight, doing a lot of damage. RTK is going to be frozen up, but now Scylla is coming in. Nice dodge there with the Manta, but isn't going to be enough. He's going to be relocated out. RTK going to get stunned up there by Blink, but CTY is back into the fight. Bian is there, going to get the silence off onto CTY on the high ground. Him is doing what he can, but it is going to be the death of Blink. And now HYM is in a little bit of... Oh no, he should be fine, actually. And yeah, just... another one fight.
just look at the fight recap.
Yeah.
Just look at the fight recap. There's like 2,488 damage by Medusa, and that's it. The rest just didn't do anything at all.
Yeah.
Whereas on the side of VG, there's 1.6k damage from Storm, a finger from Lion. There's just a lot of burst damage around.
I mean, one thing about that was Witch Doctor died before he could really get anything off, which is unfortunate, but it's going to be the middle racks going down. And yeah, I think this is just too many defensive heroes. In fact, CTY is diving in. Three-man Ravage coming up by ROTK. Very nicely done. Bian is going to be the next target. Shadow, as well as Isis, are doing what they can. Death Ward is down. Blink is back into the fight. He's going to be going to Scylla. Scylla is just going to be Etherioblading himself and trying to get out, and it looks like he's going to be fine. HYM, he could be in trouble. He's going to get the stun onto Shadow, but he does have the Lincoln Sphere, and he's going to go down. But a teleport out there by Scylla. CTY is going to get away as well. And, I mean, there was two kills there. 1.5k gold there, about 2k gold in total from the gold swing, but they did lose the rack, so sort of too little too late. And that was a buyback as well from the Slada there. He was about to respawn, but he was forced to buyback to take that engagement.
Yeah, if I were in Wings Gaming's shoes right now, and I was particularly the Slada, I would be like, I need to kill the Storm. I need to stun the Storm first. I need to stun the Storm Spirit first.
Yeah.
No, I need to go to the back line and stun out the Lion and Dazzle to prevent like the stun or the Grave from coming out. I mean, there's too many things that he has to deal with. It's just quite a big headache for Wings Gaming at the moment. They just have too many targets they need to take down.
It feels like they have been honestly outdrafted. This feels like it's a little bit of a drafting problem, and it sort of feels like they outdrafted themselves, because, you know, taking those two supports so early, two defensive supports as well, it really just gave Itchy Gaming an opportunity to counterpick them so hard, and it's just led to this situation where they don't have any damage. And while I can see what they were going for with their lineup, I mean, this Nightstalker pick was smart, but unfortunately, like you've said over and over again, there's just not enough damage to kill anyone. And the team fights are so messy because Vici Gaming are so mobile. They've got the Storm Spirit jumping around, they've got the Morphling jumping around, they've got Tide just blinking in and out. And Lion, of course, has got a blink and a four star too. It's pretty much only Burning who has got the most limited mobility, and that's literally a four star as well. And, you know, the mobility on Wings is just not there. You see, Faith has even picked up the Blink Dagger a while ago.
Exactly. There's like just a sprint on Slada. I mean, Nightstalker is naturally fast, there's Relocate, but the core of Wings Gaming, which is the Melusa, the tankiness and the damage, she's just like super immobile at the moment.
Yeah. Do you think she should pick up something like a Blink Dagger?
Possible. I still feel she needs more damage.
Yeah.
I mean, she can even go for a Scuddy at the moment. Doesn't really beef up the damage, but makes her infinitely tankier. I mean, that's the go-to that's one of the core items that Medusa needs to go for, considering that there's no Nyx assassin in the game. But I wouldn't be surprised if Medusa went for another damage item like a KB, Daedalus, or even
Rapier.
Maybe even a Divine right now, because.
Yeah.
There's no MKB on the side of VG.
Oh, looks like they're going to be going in onto Burning. He four-stuffs himself out, that mobility coming into play, but he could be stuck if they're going to take him down. Meanwhile, at the Roshan pit, Shadow just playing the annoying one, I suppose, throwing out his ultimate. He is going to actually trap CTY, but look at that, he just does nothing. He does nothing at all. Witch Doctor throwing out his ultimate from the high ground. They're going to be able to get down HYM. CTY standing on the high ground as well, wanting to go in, but a little bit scared. Witch Doctor does have the Axe, taking a lot of damage onto ROTK. ROTK is making a run for this. Is two down already. Ravage is still up. He's got his magic wand, so he should be fine. He's going to be popping it there. Meanwhile, in the backline, CTY does actually get spotted. They know he's there, and is he going to go down? Finally! He's got the Maledict on him. Yep, one more pop, and he does die at the tower. He could have killed himself, but opted not to. And that was actually three kills there. That was a really big team fight for Wings to win. And that was right at the Roshan pit, so...
No.
ROTK, he might go in, though. He's got the Ravage. Are they going to try and fight this? A little bit too late for him now. So that's Cheese and Aegis.
And the gem.
And the gem, yeah. So wait, did they just get the
gem and...
Nobody picked it up? Oh my god. That's a bit derpy.
The gem was right at the tier 2 tower.
Yeah, I saw him die there. I thought maybe someone could get it.
Yeah.
The supports must be raging now. That's like support woes. You know, you buy a gem for your carry and he loses it and you're like, someone, you know, drop your Quelling Blade. It's 39 minutes. Pick it up and you're like, nah. Just leave the gem on the floor. It's fine. Well, that was a pretty big actual comeback there for Wings. They're in it to win it.
It's a really big ghost swing. Looks like Shadow's actually gonna pick up the Maelstrom. Probably going to the Milner. In terms of raw damage, he could actually go MKB.
Shadow in trouble, maybe?
Maelstrom really helps.
Wow. Yeah, I agree. I think the Maelstrom is gonna be, like you said, damage is what he needs, and that will help as well with popping the Lincoln Sphere on the Morphling. If he can get some procs off in the fight, it might help just a little bit to, you know, chainstun him a bit more. Maybe, possibly.
I forgot about the Maelstrom Milner build. But it really works well with Medusa, considering that she's super tanky. She just needs, like, attack speed right now since she has Butterfly, and it really works well. Fast attack speed with the Milner and the Chain Lightning passive.
Yeah.
I still think VG have the upper hand at the moment because the fight they just lost at Roshan was because Burning got picked off. Their team was just, you know, they were just split up, and yeah, they didn't really get a good engage off. Ravage wasn't really used.
And honestly, they didn't have to lose CTY. He was just standing there for 30 seconds.
On too late, Wings will definitely have the upper hand.
Yeah. I mean, Medusa is one of the scariest late game carries.
Yeah, I mean, Medusa is probably the ultimate carry, like the ultimate late game carry. In terms of tankiness, damage dealt. Yeah, the only thing that Medusa struggles in is in the mobility department.
Yeah.
She's probably just like the biggest, tankiest tower, standing tower right there. Yeah, but she's just really incredibly slow and like immobile.
Well, I mean, as we saw, when you get Stone Gaze, you take 50% bonus physical damage, and she did manage to Stone Gaze the Storm, and she wasn't even tickling him, he just was laughing at her. So, I mean, she really is in need of damage, but like I said as well, she needs stats to keep herself a little bit more tanky, so I think Medusa is quite far from being sort of six-slotted like she needs to be, but she's getting there. I mean, so she's going to have the Mjolnir up now, so probably room for Skadi, Boots Travel, and then replace something to grab, you know, something like a Divine Rapier or a pure damage item. What do you think she should replace?
I think for now it's fine that she goes for, like, you know, Skadi BOT. But if she were to replace, like, an item, I don't know.
I mean, normally I'd say the Mjolnir, but she just bought it.
Yeah, but I think if she wants to, she needs to throw out like one item. It's either a Skadi or a Divine Rapier right now.
Yeah.
I'll definitely opt for the Skadi because, you know, I'm a safer player and it doesn't really make sense to go on Divine right now since she has like quite a bit of damage right now.
Yeah.
If she can get like way tankier with the Skadi, it will serve her better. She'll be able to dish out more damage in the clash.
Yeah. I mean, one thing as well that we had not mentioned is with the Wisp overcharge, she's going to get a lot of procs on this Mjolnir. So as long as the Wisp can actually stay alive in the team fights, she will be hitting quite hard, which means the Divine Rapier might not be necessary. But that, of course, does depend on the Wisp not dying while he's channeling that overcharge.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Yeah, and like I said earlier, Medusa is just one of those heroes that fight against Mega Creeps. Yeah. I don't know how many times I've seen like teams go down and like fighting against Mega Creeps only to win the game later by just, you know, playing the buyback game.
Yeah. Could be an engagement. Aegis just died and Avicii Gaming did smoke up in time. High ground advantage though, going the way of Wings right now. They will throw the stun out and then Witch Doctor blinking away. Morphling Sylar just coming forward and they're going to be trying to go forward. They're onto Faith. Faith is going to be able to pop the BKB and get away. But now in comes the Wisp and the Medusa right into the middle of the fight. Wisp immediately dead. Double Ravage coming out. Shadow taking heaps and heaps and heaps of damage. He doesn't even have enough mana to throw his ultimate out. And down he goes. Sylar there with a double kill. Ice Ice is going to be the next one to go down there. Triple kill onto him. Blink is going to be the target of choice next. He's Silent Star. Finger of Death on him. He pops the armor. Trying to get away but slowed down way too much. And going to CTY and he'll ultra kill Sylar. But four dead there. They're going to have to buy back. This is going to be Mega Creep so they don't buy back. Well, that was just a terrible fight. Medusa didn't pop her ultimate.
It was a disaster, man. It was a disaster. I mean, I think Wings just wanted to back out. They saw VG smoke with the nice Stalker Vision.
Yeah. Two buybacks?
I think one of them actually broke the smoke. But I think they just miscommunication again. They look like they wanted to back out, but the Redo Kick came in, which came in without the Storm Gaze, so caused them four deaths and two buybacks.
And it looks like they want to make something happen. It's still night time. In fact, it's just the start of night, but no Witch Doctor yet. They are pinging out onto Faith. They maybe want to chase him. CTY, they're just ruffle-balling very far away. So it looks like they're happy with two buybacks. Roshan is going to be up in around about 2 or 3 minutes, so do you think they're just going to wait for that and then just try and end?
Yeah, just Aegis on the Storm, just zip in and wreck the entire backline. I think VG are in prime position to take the game, comes the game out. But then again, there's always the Medusa factor, so As long as Wings Gaming doesn't like repeat that disastrous engage, I think they'll be fine because I feel the Medusa can just stand and just hit the tier 3 tower on his own. they don't really have an answer for it. That was just a really bad engage. Like, he just relocated Madame Medusa
right on the line.
Made off five heroes.
Double ravage on his head. I mean, that could have gone differently if he'd thrown the stone gaze out before the relocate. Like, if they relocate, then he stone gazes and they land in with the stone gaze up. That could go differently, but unfortunately, they obviously weren't prepared, and then they just dead. They died pretty much immediately.
It was like double ravage in the face. She didn't even like dish up any damage at all.
It's not where you want to be.
I don't even think she managed to get the stone gaze off.
No, she was out of mana. Yeah. She came in, was out of mana, and died.
Yeah. It's just a disaster.
And you can sort of see the tail of this game right now in the gold graph. You know, steadily in favor of Vichy Gaming. It looks like they're going to make a comeback, and then they throw another team fight. And suddenly, you know, Vichy Gaming are 12,000 in the lead in gold. And same with experience. It's a bit up and down, but still in Vichy Gamers' advantage. And you can see them just camping around the Roshan pit. They want to get this Aegis. Even Wings is sort of lurking around, but Ice is going to go back and defend. That's a bit interesting. I would have thought he'd stay around and they'd send the Wisp Medusa back, but I suppose they learned their lesson from last fight that they can't relocate in to defend. So they will get trashed. And yeah, if there is a fight now, it's going to be without Ice.
We actually see the split pushing potential right now, forcing the Witch Doctor back. Yeah, like we said, definitely can send a better hero there to defend against the split push, but yeah, I mean, VG have the split pushing capabilities, like what he's doing right now. He just replicated the Storm, pushing out top lane, so now he can actually take down the Rex and defend Roche at the same time.
Dido and Medusa, this could be a very good fight, and then they go stun. Not going to land on anyone, unfortunately. Medusa coming with the Stone Gaze. ROTK is going to be the target of choice. They really want to get him down, but he is just so tanky. Burning pops the Ghost Scepter, is going to run away now. Bian going in onto Burning, but Grave's already on ROTK. They will get Burning down. Meanwhile, the Toprax is going down at the same time. Now Shadow in the middle of the fight. One Ravage is down, two Ravages down. Shadow just turned to stun. HYM is going to be going down on the sideline. Double kill there. Killing spree on to Bian. Looks like they will be able to get down a buyback from the Lion, as well as Tide going down. Now chasing after CTY, Bian's coming in. He's going to get force up out there by HYM. HYM. Oh yeah, there's Mega Creeps. Damn! Sylar being so sneaky. I mean, they're winning the fight, but it's not worth it. Shadow now going head-to-head with Sylar under the Tier 2 tower. Not a good decision, as Tier 2 tower is now to the same damage as Tier 3. No buyback on Medusa, dead for 100 seconds, and GG is going to be called out now. Easy rat by Sylar. Ouch.
That escalated quickly.
Yeah, that was like, they're winning a fight. No, wait. It's because Sylar's not there. Ouch. Well, GG. Well played to both teams. It is a best of three, so Vichy Gaming are going to be taking the first game. I've got one, if not two more games coming up. So thanks for casting with me, Chu, and I'll see you all in the next game.